belongs to a Nawab, and Nawab built it for himself. But recently there was a picture which is Arundhati picture, and they used this palace for the shooting, and hence this palace became Arundhati Kota. So now I'll take you through to the Arundhati Kota. This is the main entrance where they seized the entrance, and now here we have to go from here to see the Arundhati Kota. See the whole stone layout and the wood which has been used is the original teak wood, and the steel which has been used is not yet damaged. Everything is up to mark now. So here we will go ahead from here, and when we go inside this kota, you can see there are few things which will even shock you about the infrastructure, about the architecture, and about the technology used to make this kota. If you come from here, see the amount of steel which has been used, and then the level of curvature and the slab which has been built in such a way where the architecture is like a mosque or the church, which has been used for the mosque and the church. And you can see the flooring also. The flooring is also a very different flooring. In these days, it appears to be a royal flooring. And the way they made this hall is like, you know, a hall where the king will sit here, and the whole like, you know, kota has been developed in such a way. Now this kota got its name back, and people started developing this kota. Now we can have the glimpse of this kota. See, the doors have been locked because people might plug the doors, hence the doors have been locked. See the status, see how it has been maintained. If people like the IT department people and those who are interested in history and architecture, those people can come over, they can take their time and look this kota and invest some of their time. We can save this from damages. Thank you.